show your show no credit. We show your bro for leverage. What a hypocrite said. What community feel that the only one's relevant? What a hypocrite said. What community feel that the only one's relevant? You out of pocket, yeah, you out of pocket. You entertain the mediocre, need to stop it. You entertaining old friends when they toxic. What your life like? What the fuck is council culture, dog? Say what I want about you, I'm like overdog. I treat you like I'm Jigga, watch I own it, dog. Oh, you worry about a critic, that ain't protocol.
Y'all in the house with it. We don't respect fake jewelry and silly outfits. Window down, blowing out great tits. New York's Jay Prince on Houston Street. I caught the bounce before my even bounced the beat. I took the hard way and it, man, it's the route for me. Run me the keys, run me the bees, run me that flow back. Your top three, I'm not number one, how could you post that? I would have crowned the city is mine, you cannot hold that. I'm not the one to go at, meet Joe Black. Run me the keys, run me the bees, run me that flow back. Your top three, I'm not number one, how could you post that? I would have crowned the city is mine, you cannot hold that. I'm not the one to go at, meet Joe Black, meet Joe Black.
Make a choice. I need 100 pack for my boys. Did be hating and talking and hating. I bet you I kill the noise. I've been a man like I'm painting. I boost up my rating. You know how I play with toys. Pop out on any occasion, get standing ovations. They can't help it but rejoice. They all wanna follow me, cause I got my foot on the opposition neck and ain't no apologies. 100 yards, you know I own all the property. Daddy's homie, know I own all the property.
You gotta choose. You like the top or you just like to lose. Make a move. Been at the bottom, I got to prove. You gotta choose. You like the top or you just like to lose. Make a move. Been at the bottom, I got to prove. You gotta choose. You like the top or you just like to lose. Make a move. Been at the bottom, I got to prove. You gotta choose. You like the top or you just like to lose. Make a move. Been at the bottom, I got to prove. You gotta choose.
Tonight, it's Madden NFL football. Super Bowl 57.
Sports coverage of the National Football League is on the air. We count down to kickoff in what should be an epic one here, as it'll be the AFC champion Kansas City Chiefs taking on the champions from the NFC, the Minnesota Vikings. Brandon Gaudin alongside Charles Davis. And Charles, for these Kansas City Chiefs, they, of course, were Super Bowl champions 3 years ago. The win over the Niners in Miami. They fell to the Bucs in Tampa a couple years back. They had the blown lead in the AFC title game against Cincinnati last year. And now they're back, making their third trip to the big game in 4 years.
And their recent history only increases the urgency to try and win another Super Bowl title with this group.
Meanwhile, the Minnesota Vikings are back in the big game for the fifth time in franchise history. But we all know one thing has eluded them all these years.
And that's an actual Super Bowl victory, partner. They're 0-4 in their previous visits, Super Bowls 4, 8, 9, and 11. And boy, they had some great teams too, didn't they? Bud Grant was their head coach, Fran Tarkenton a quarterback, Alan Page and the Purple People Eaters on defense. They were all Hall of Famers. And don't forget Paul Krause. He's a very proud member of that great secondary they had. So we're going back more than 40 years since their last visit. You think the state of Minnesota is excited about this one? I know they are. They're ready to get this one going.
The stage is finally set, and here we go. Super Bowl 57 is underway. Fielded just outside the goal line. Oh, a good return up past the 30.
Come on, get me. Let's go.
So here's the Viking offense making their way out. And they will be led out by their rookie quarterback.
And as we know and as we've discussed here in the run-up to this game, this is history in the making. The first rookie quarterback to ever start in a Super Bowl. An absolutely tremendous accomplishment, something no one else has done. But he doesn't want to just go down as the first to make a Super Bowl. He's told us all week he's here to win it.
The first carry now for Dalvin Cook. 4 yards the pickup, first down. Back to throw. Rich, catch is made by Hockenson, the tight end. And they'll get this down to around the 47-yard line. More muscle up front for this second and two. They've got three tight ends out there. Handoff comes to Cook. Shifts by him. And great blocking downfield as he's got this almost to the 35-yard line. It's a gain of 11 as the Vikings pick up the first. This Super Bowl, of course, just a huge one for this head coach. The first time he's walked the sidelines in a game of this magnitude. And you know, I might normally ask the cliche, what's going through his mind right now? But maybe the better question, CD, what do you think are the pitfalls of being a first-time head coach in this game?
Well, you know it's something that he thought about, Brandon, and he had to, and he was thinking about it long before he got to this stage. As the season progressed and he saw that his team was good, if he was smart, he started to make plans right then and there. Reach out to other coaches who've been there before. Find out how they handled winning, losing, handling all the ticket situations, travel, practice, all those things, and then trust your gut, make your best decision, and put it all out there and give your team their best chance to win.
Looking to throw on second down. Rich, and that falls to the ground, incomplete. A nice job of bodying him up defensively, and now it brings up third down. On third down, Rich. Got his man complete over the middle. It's Osborne. And he'll be brought down with a first down as the tackle's made at the Chiefs 19. That one goes for 13 yards and it moves the sticks. So here's a first and 10 now down inside the 20. From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. And this is caught at the 8. And the Vikings are going to have a first and goal as he's taken down at about the 8-yard line. Operating from the gun, Rich. And it's caught. Touchdown, Vikings. TJ Hockenson. From 8 yards out, and the Vikings are on the board first here in this Super Bowl. A long opening drive, but a very successful opening drive. We call that methodical, I guess, when it takes that many plays.
Methodical and almost like a boxing match where you're hitting them with body blows. They can withstand them here. Look, they gave up the touchdown, but you don't feel like a knockout is there. But they keep doing that in the fourth quarter. That's when the knockout occurs.
And it becomes tough for that defense if they're on the field that long. We'll see if they can continue that in future drives. Joseph connects on the extra point, and that makes the score 7-0. That time, a 9-play drive. And it was TJ Hockenson who finished the drive with a touchdown reception. Now Joseph tees it up to kick off following the touchdown. And Hardman going to go ahead and sit on this one as it'll come out to the 25. The KC offense set to go, led as always by the gunslinger, a former MVP in this league. It's Patrick Mahomes.
You can't help but continue to marvel at how well this man's career has gone so far. Now in his fifth season as KC starter, he's never missed a conference title game, and he's taking the field in his third Super Bowl. Simply dominant, it's easy to envision him being one of the top quarterbacks for many years to come.
They'll start this drive out on the ground. He'll be dropped after a gain of about 6 across the 30 to the 31. They'll come up now 2nd and 4 from the 31. From the gun, they'll try to run it.
Come on, boys!
A gain of five, good enough for the first down. Throwing now is Mahomes. Oh, it's a screen pass. That's complete. And this will be stopped at the 44. That one good for 7 yards.
And good yardage there on first down, because sometimes all you need to do on the screen is get one key block. That might set your man free, and that was pretty good pursuit to the football defensively, or it could have gone for more.
Here's a handoff out of the gun. And he'll get it out a couple yards shy of midfield at the 48. 4 yards the pickup, first down.
It's nice every now and then in this game not to see people overthink it. Just hand it to the old reliable guy, let him pick up the first down.
Throwing on first down is Mahomes. Now they set up the screen, that's complete. And they'll get him down on the other side of midfield. Looking to throw again on second down. Mahomes. And this is going to turn into another first down as the tackle is made at the Vikings 34-yard line. From the 34 now, here's first and 10. Here's Mahomes to throw. He'll find Smith-Schuster. That's complete. A pickup of about 3 yards as he's taken down at the 31. But yet another completion here on this opening drive, and he's now perfect 4 of 4 to start. Pretty solid execution here.
And how about how everyone's handled their nerves? Because you know what it's like to start a ball game. You're so amped up and ready to go, and sometimes the execution isn't there. They've been flawless so far. Well drilled, well prepared, and excited to start this game.
He'll be dropped at the 25 after a gain of 6.
They gave up the completion there, but this is what zone defenses count on. Catching the ball and not much run after the catch.
Ninth play coming up here on this drive. This is third and a yard. One back in the backfield. He'll get the carry. They'll be marked inches short. No gain on the play, and that's going to lead them to fourth down. They'll try and run for it. And they are going to stop him on fourth and one as they'll wind up going backwards. The Chiefs tried it, but they're turned away on fourth down. And the Vikings defense is going to get the football back. Well, I guess they wanted to get that touchdown right back on their first drive, but failed to do so.
And what they have to be careful of is pushing so hard to stay right there, to stay even with their opponent, that they gas themselves out. You know, it's almost like horse racing. Sometimes you don't want to take your horse right to the front and let them do all the work and then someone catch them at the end and pass them up. You want to make sure you moderate what you're doing along the way and then go for the big finish.
Well, CD, a lot of times like to separate speed and quickness, and they've got a back that's both. We know that he's fast in the open field, but man, his first step is so quick too.
It is something, isn't it? Because you think of that type of speed getting to the perimeter and turning upfield, but also when you run those inside runs, he can get into the secondary so fast the linebackers don't have a chance to react.
To throw on second down. Rich looks again for TJ Hockenson, and he's got him again. They'll wind up getting just a yard out of it. And third and 8 now. Looking to throw. Rich, he rifles one that's intercepted. And the Chiefs are going to take possession of the football. That time defensively looked like they showed quite a bit of pressure, but backed off, and it proved fruitful. They get the pick.
He went through all of his rules about getting rid of the ball quickly because he read blitz. He saw all those people stacked at the line of scrimmage, and then they fooled him by dropping into coverage. Now he's ready to get rid of the ball fast, but guess what? Too many defenders out there. Exactly as you described, an interception.
Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10. So after the INT, here's Mahomes. Oh, this one incomplete. The pressure got to him as he released it. And it's second down. Back to the air on second down. It's Mahomes. And this one taken in on the right sideline, but not in the field of play. They say it's incomplete. The throw led him a little too far and brings up third down. Shotgun snap to Mahomes. Pressure coming from the Vikings, and they get there and bring him down. He could not get away that time, and it'll be a loss of 11 on third down.
Well, they've been fighting and scratching and clawing for that first sack in the game, and it turns out to be a big one. Not just a short one right there behind the line. First one they get, 10-plus yards, and a guy who has the legs to escape most of these.
So now on comes the field goal unit, and wow, this is no ordinary try here. And this is off target to the left, didn't get there anyway. It's no good, and this will stay at a 7-point game. Minnesota's offense takes over possession. They've got a 7-0 lead in the football as well as they start out first and 10.
And this is a commentary on today's kickers and just how good they are that a coach would think about running his guy out there to try a 59-yarder. Here it backfires on them, but as a kicker, you have to appreciate the confidence that they showed in you.
On first and 10. Rich, open here, Adam Thielen. And they'll work this down inside the 30. Back-to-back good plays have them on the move on first down. Out of the gun, they'll look to throw. Throw caught there by Osborne. And he'll be marked down right at the 20-yard line. A give. This is Cook. And all the way down inside the 5 to the 4. 43 yards rushing for him now in the opening quarter of this Super Bowl.
They're making it look easy out there. Another first down. So far on this drive, let me do this little bit of math here. 4 plays, 3 first downs.
That's a pretty good recipe for success. It looks like a jumbo set with 3 tight ends here for first and goal. Cook will get about halfway there as he takes this from the 4 down to the 2. From the 2 now, second and goal. They'll try to run with Madison. And he pushes forward but comes up short of the goal line as he'll get a yard down to about the 1.
His path became similar to almost running a stretch play, didn't it? Trying to find a crease, anywhere to put his foot in the ground and cut back. It just never materialized.
A big one here early in this Super Bowl. It's third and goal. Back to throw. Rich. And it's caught in the end zone for the Viking touchdown by Justin Jefferson. A 1-yard touchdown pass. And the Vikings will add to their first quarter lead here in this Super Bowl. Solid response that time by a young quarterback. Last drive, interception. This drive, the touchdown pass.
I like how you described it, solid, because you don't get extra kudos for bouncing back if you're going to be a big-time quarterback.
And we remember, of course, all scoring plays need to be verified upstairs, and I think they're going to at least take a look at this. They're taking a peek at whether or not those feet were in bounds, and obviously a big call here in the end zone.
And not just the feet. How about the hands? How's the ball possessed while the feet are hopefully getting down in bounds? That's what they're trying to look at to see if it all comes together.
So they called it a touchdown originally, and this will stay a touchdown after the video review, so they had it right. Joseph connects on the extra point, and that'll make the score 14-0. So that winds up a 7-play drive all told. And it was all capped off by Justin Jefferson's touchdown reception. Now Joseph tees it up to kick off following the touchdown. Taken at the goal line. And he'll take it up past the 25 to the 26-yard line. And now this offense comes back out onto the field. They trail early on in this Super Bowl as they come up first and 10. They come up with exactly 1 minute to go in this first quarter. Mahomes now on first down. Completes it to Hardman. And they're able to get this one across the 35. So here's a first and 10 at the 38. From the gun, he'll hand this off. And he's going to be stopped up quickly here. Just a yard up to the 39. One quarter done, three more to play here in Super Bowl 57. 14-0 is our score. The NFL on EA Sports continues right after this message. On second and 9, Mahomes, it's Kelce on the ground. And this is going to turn into another first down as the tackle is made at the Vikings 43. They give him 17 yards that time as that'll move the chains.
A lot of tight ends just use their size and their strength, try to occupy some space and kind of body people away and catch the football. But not this guy. He's a refined route runner. Makes me wonder if he took some dance classes in his background with his footwork.
This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. On first down, they'll go to the ground attack. This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8-yard gain, second and 2. From the 35 on second down, Mahomes. And they will finally stop him as he's down to the 40-yard line. Before we came up to the booth, last thing he said as we were walking off the field, want to play mistake-free football. Well, that just went out the window there with a pick.
Andy, do you remember what you said to me when we were walking up to the booth after he said that? You're like, oh, fatal last words. Every time we hear that, things tend to fall apart a little bit, and that's what we saw there. Didn't get enough on that throw, and it turned into an interception.
Now a play fake here on first down. And Cook has it, left side. And the tackle going to be made at the 38. Looking to throw on second down. Rich dancing to his left. And he slings one that's incomplete. The Vikings on third down. They've been okay, 2 for 3 thus far. This is 3rd and 8. Looking to throw. Rich. He's going to get this one down to Cook. And they'll get him down at the 34, and he's going to be short of the first by a few yards. He did his best to just get 4 out of that, but not enough. And now 4th down.
Well, offensively, that's the mismatch that you want. You want to force a linebacker to try and cover your back out of the backfield, out in some open space. But linebackers nowadays, they run like backs, and they take a lot of pride in covering. What a nice play he made there in the open field.
Here's Greg Joseph now to try the field goal. On the right hash, officially this will be a 51-yard attempt. Joseph's got it, and that will extend their lead even further. The early lead, and they get the interception, Charles, and now they add 3 more with the field goal.
Yeah, they're in control of how this game is playing out so far. You mentioned the early lead. Now they're expanding on it, getting plays on both sides of the ball. A winning recipe if they can keep this up.
The Chiefs ready to rock again on offense. As the offense comes out here, Charles, remember they threw the interception last time out, but they were moving the football down the field. Looked like they were going to have a sustained drive that ended in points. but then the pick ensued.
And because of that, there's no way you can call the last drive a success. Yes, there are things to build on because they found some play calls at work. Now, they've got to build another drive and find a way to avoid the turnover that plagued it on the last one.
Certainly appeared to take away his first read, and by the time he tried to look elsewhere and find an open target, the coverage was too good. That one falls incomplete.
So the incompletion, and now it's second and 10, again from the 25-yard line. Mahomes' throw here complete to Kelsey. And they work this well upfield across the 45. A gain there of 21 yards. Been a very one-sided game so far. They got to change what they're doing right now, don't they? You can't wait till the halftime speech to make an adjustment.
No, you can't, because if you're doing it right, you're adjusting from series to series, and they need a big adjustment here to try and put some points on the board.
And they'll run on the inside handoff, and he'll take this ahead for about four. Second down coming up. The run got four. Now they deal with a second and six. Hands it off out of the gun. And still about 3 yards shy of a first as the four-yard pickup brings it to third down.
When you find that kind of yardage, you couldn't be more confident as a ball carrier. And guess what? You're going to go back and tell your offensive coordinator, I'd like to keep carrying it, thank you.
Mahomes looks to throw on third down. Man open, it's Toni. He's got it. And he will have a Chiefs first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
This offense is starting to get into rhythm. A nice quick throw there on target, able to pick up another first down.
Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. One back in the backfield, he'll get the carry. Yeah, boy, this defense again really making things tough on him as they stop him for no gain.
They just keep trying, but so far, finding no room for him to run.
None whatsoever. In fact, you run the numbers, he's under 3 yards a carry at the moment. Working from the gun, Mahomes. Open man right side is Smith-Schuster, complete. And he'll be brought down at the 27.
Of course, the catch was nice, but how about what happened after? Able to stay on his feet and gain all that additional yardage. So many of these slot guys, I think, have running back in their background.
They fake the give. Now Mahomes. He's going to go down here, a sack. They push him back to the 34. Danielle Hunter coming in for that outside linebacker spot, and he buries him for a loss of 7.
Three scores down, not even a halftime yet. They are not getting much generated offensively. They've got to figure it out.
It's tough because this defense just seems to be playing with so much confidence right now.
They really are. They are on their toes, and they're getting at them.
So second and long, and got to be careful not to fall out of field goal range. Another try after the first down sack. Mahomes, and he'll be marked down at about the 26-yard line. Throwing is Mahomes on third. And he's going to be taken down back around the 35-yard line. Za'Darius Smith in there to get him for a loss of 9 yards, and that also leads to fourth down. These sacks now, they're starting to pile up, Charles, and that front seven defensively, they've had their way with this offensive line.
And I think at this stage, we have to start thinking about different play calls. We've got to start helping this quarterback out because the entire game he's been under siege. I don't care what the down and distance, they've got to get the ball out of his hands a lot quicker.
Butker's kick here is good. And they're on the board at least here. It's now 17-3. It's So he missed his first attempt, remember, but this time he gets back on the bike and knocks it home.
Yeah, and sometimes that first one can really impact you moving forward. It can just stay with you too long and affect everything else you do during the game. In this case, though, able to shake it off. He's riding high again.
You see Dalvin Cook and the offense heading back out. The passing game, they've had more success there than the running game. Maybe something they game plan for.
How come they didn't tell us about it?
Because they wanted to keep it a secret.
We did ask, didn't we? But I think what happened in this one is they've realized that they've established the run pretty well, and teams are going to key on that. They thought they could open it up and have success through the air, and that's exactly what's going on.
Yeah, they've had success at least so far here in the second quarter. And this will be a Vikings first down as he's got this up to the 45-yard line.
So right now what I'm seeing an offense just firing off the ball a lot quicker than they can react. And not only that, they're sustaining the blocks too. I'm seeing guys get 6-7 yards downfield before there's even a hint of contact.
First down, Rich. This one into the hands of Thielen. He'll get it inside the 20, and he'll get into the end zone. Touchdown, Minnesota. Adam Thielen, 55 yards. And the Vikings continue to look good here in the first half of this Super Bowl. As a former DB, you might not like to see that, but from a wide receiver's perspective, those are the plays they dream of.
Correct on both counts, all right? Because once he took off, I mean, let's face it, that should have been done in Big Sky Country. Aren't any speed limits out there? And off he went. Glad I wasn't the one trying to chase him.
Joseph connects on the extra point, and the lead now to 3 touchdowns at 21. The long touchdown pass gets him 6 on a very, very tidy 2-play drive that time. Hardman will elect not to bring this out, and the football will be on the 25-yard line. Now this Chiefs offense gets set to go again. Last time out, you remember their drive stalled, but thanks to their kicker, booted a long field goal to at least get them 3. Now here they'll try to do better and find the end zone.
And in our experience, how much fun is it for coaches to know that they've got a kicker who can nail it from long distance? Now, the hard part is, as an offensive play caller, you don't want that in your head too much where you're relying on it. And he goes out and gets the job done for them. But I'm quite sure he would be content to just kick extra points from here on out.
Yeah, absolutely, no question. I think his teammates would be okay with him just kicking the extra points as well. Mahomes again here on 2nd and 10. Well, Mahomes can't get away, and down he goes. Za'Darius Smith, that is now 2 sacks for him here in this first half.
How about that, partner? His 2nd sack of the game, and that puts him in some pretty good company. 17 guys have had 2 sacks in the previous 52 Super Bowls, but only 3 have had the record number of 3 sacks in this game.
And we've got the list here. If he gets another one and everyone behaves nicely, we might just list those out for him. After the sack, things get a little tougher here. 3rd and long for Mahomes and the Chiefs. They'll look to throw. A battle for it, and it's intercepted. It's Cameron Dantzler who picks it. And the Vikings are going to take possession of the football. Well, that one was in the air for an agonizingly long time.
Just begging to be picked off, wasn't it? It's one thing if you're throwing a ball like that, trying to throw someone open or lead them into an area. But that ball needed to be thrown with a lot more conviction. As a result, it's an easy interception.
And now out comes Minnesota. It's a quick turnaround for them after the turnover, but the way they moved it on their last drive, they're probably eager to get right back at it.
And you know me and you know my tendencies in this situation. What do I want right now?
Be aggressive.
Be aggressive. Take your shot right here.
And the first play of the drive there is incomplete. After the incomplete pass, here now is 2nd and 10. Operating from the gun, Rich. Open man is Osborne. He's got it. And he'll be brought down on the other side of midfield at the 43.
The offense on third down tonight, they've hit 2 for 4 thus far. This will be 3rd and 6. And he's taken down, a Chiefs sack.
Willie Gay getting in there and picking up the sack.
Traditionally, as a defense, your number one job, stop the run. But in today's football, it's impacting the opposing quarterback. Make him uncomfortable. And so far, they've not been able to do that.
Not at all. He's been really comfortable in the pocket. 3 touchdown passes already.
So that could be an important first sack if they do want to turn things around.
So on 4th down, on is the punter, Ryan Wright.
And this one's out of bounds. Should be inside the 10, I think it is, at the 6-yard line.
Let's go old school there. That's absolutely a great coffin corner punt. Someone's put some time in working on that, hasn't it?
Seems like every year these guys get better and better. It's amazing how they can command that football through the air.
Yeah, they used to actually practice with hula hoops where they place them and try and put them there. Now a lot of guys use barrels on the sidelines to try and put the football in one.
Trying to shake off the interception. He'll look to throw. They'll try and set up the screen. It's complete. And they'll get him down right around the 11-yard line. The first down screen pass, good for 5.
And a really nice play call there to start the drive, especially if you're a team that has a little bit of a reputation for throwing it downfield. You come out, and you think maybe you can catch them off guard a little bit, and they did. Little screen pass, backdoored them, and that time worked well for a solid game.
They come up now 3rd and 5 following the incomplete pass. Looking to throw is Mahomes. And for the 3rd time here in this half, it's intercepted. It's Cameron Dantzler who picks it. And he will take this one home. It's a touchdown.
Well, this defense, they've been terrific all year, and they come through with a pick 6 here on the game's biggest stage.
Perfect descriptor there, because we have seen this time and time again. This defense, their ability to take the ball away from teams, they definitely have a nose for the football, and it pays off again on that play.
Joseph now to have the PAT. And that'll increase their lead to 28. A heck of a play there defensively, getting the interception, navigating his way into the end zone for the touchdown. So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick 6, and now the kick is away.
Fields it right around the goal line. And the tackle going to be made right there at the 25-yard line. And Kansas City's offense now set and ready to go.
They are looking to make a bit of a 180. They are sputtering right now.
And frankly, I think it's time to call your playmakers together and say, all right, guys, we're going to lean on you through this patch. We need you to get us back on track and get us going in the right direction. So you're calling plays geared to them. Not necessarily what you look at your plays, oh, this hurts the defense. I want the ball in the hands of X, Y, and Z and see if we can move forward.
So don't get too cute. Go to the playmakers.
This defense has really flown around in the first half. They've gotten to the ball carrier before they can really get started. Offense gonna have to come up with something else in order to try and get this running game going.
After the loss to start out, here's 2nd and 11. And they'll give him another shot here on the ground. And he'll fight forward to about the 27-yard line. To throw, it's Mahomes. And for the 4th time tonight, it's an interception.
Picked off by Chandon Sullivan. And the Vikings are going to take possession of the football. Well, that is interception number 4 for him, Charles. 4 here in the first half alone. And they're already trailing by 4 possessions.
Makes me wonder, partner, do they just not have any confidence at all in the backup? Or do they just have that much confidence in him? Able to throw 4 picks already, they're certainly hoping that he can turn things around and quickly.
Minnesota's offense takes over possession.
They were forced to punt last time, and I doubt sincerely that they'll have to punt here because they're gifted with terrific field position.
I don't even want to think about the idea that they would end up punting starting with this type of field position. Neither do they. Great starting spot, great opportunity to run your full playbook. They want to take a shot here, they can go ahead and do it.
They run it again with Cook. He winds up getting only a couple there, down to the 29. The 22 is the line to gain here on third down. Operating from the gun, Rich. And that is incomplete. Oh, he had a defender right there with him to force that to the ground. And fourth down now coming up.
Well, partner, given where that drive started, that's an excellent job defensively to force them into fourth down.
Now Greg Joseph for the field goal try. Made his first, this now from 46 yards away. The kick by Joseph is good, and that will extend their lead even further. So the interception set him up with terrific field position, but 3 points, the end result.
Yeah, we can make this one pretty simple, partner. You always want to end drives with points. But that's one that you're going to look back on and probably say, we should have done better there.
And able to get this out to the 25. And now here comes Kansas City. They're sort of seeing themselves spiral out of control. Let's see if they can get things back on track.
And this is where the coach is walking that line of being calm and really being firm with his team. Had one tell me once, you know, when we were having a tough patch, this too shall pass, and finally we kept having a rough patch. He said, but you got to do something to make it pass, and that's what they have to do. They've got to get some control back, get themselves reasserted, and calm things down.
See if they can get calm and reassert themselves here. Minutes on the clock in the second quarter of this Super Bowl. We remind you that coming up at halftime, Jonathan Coachman will be alongside. He'll have highlights and analysis from Orlando of this first half of action. Now a throw here to his running back. The Vikings going to signal for the first of their timeouts. So as they take it over, we step aside. On third down, they'll try and run for it on the draw. And not a whole lot to speak of there, as they'll bring him down shy of the 20. Now a second timeout called for by the defense as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. On is the punter, Townsend, as he gets this one away. That'll go as a 46-yard punt with a return of 7. And the Vikings will take over here, 1st and 10. Dalvin Cook taking the field for the Vikings' next possession. And it may just be the second quarter, but he's in the zone, well on his way to eclipsing that 100-yard mark.
And when a back has a game, as we're witnessing right now, his name's going to be in the books. But it's really a collective deal, isn't it? Because that means he's getting plenty of blocking, a lot of help from his teammates, but he's making the most of it.
Yeah, he's made the most of it to this point. Throwing on first down, Rich. He's got his tight end over the middle, TJ Hockenson. And they're going to get this down to about the 37.
I like how they worked the tight end on a nice little under route there. And if you're going to give him that much space, he's not even going to catch the football. He's going to run away from me a little bit. And that's exactly what he just did there, picking up extra yardage.
Over the middle, complete. That's Osborne. And this will go as a gain of 7 as he gets it to the 30-yard line. They'll look to throw again. That one into the hands of Thielen, complete. And he'll be out of bounds as he gets this down about the 21 or 22. They go play action here on first down. He finds his man complete. It's Osborne. So with 4 seconds to go in the half, here's the field goal unit onto the field. It's a 39-yard attempt, right hash. Joseph's got it, and that will extend their lead even further. So he's been a busy man here in this first half. That's 3 field goals for him now.
And not just 3 field goals, but 3 for 3. So even though the offense has struggled a bit putting it in the end zone, he's still been able to come away with points due to his leg.
No reason to do anything foolish as they'll snap it one more time on first down. And with time running short here, they'll simply take a knee, and that should do it for half number one. So we've reached halftime here in the Super Bowl, as now we send you out to Orlando and hook back up with Jonathan Coachman for our EA Sports Halftime Report.
Okay, Brandon, thanks very much. What a season this has been. Hard to believe it ends tonight, as we'll get back to you guys for the second half of this Super Bowl in just a moment. Thus far, this Super Bowl has looked less like a contest and more like a coronation. And to call the second half, let's get it right back out to Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.